Hi, I'm Sharita McNeil Denning here with In Due Season Outreach Ministry community event right here at the corner of Carver and Boyer Street.
We are In Due Season Outreach Ministry, amen. And we are out here to spread the love of Jesus, amen. We are out here to spread the love of Jesus, amen. Amen. The word said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, amen. So we are here to spread the love of Jesus, amen? Amen. And what we've been based on is scriptural base, and it's called Galatians 6:9. But I'm going to start at chapter 6, and we're going to begin at verse 7, amen? And it says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap everlasting life. And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Amen?
Praise God. Let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we come before you today. Thank you for another great day. Thank you for the things that you have done today and the things that you're doing. We thank you for our future. Father God, we ask you right now in the name of your Son Jesus to move every yoke and bust every yoke that needs to be bust right there in the name of Jesus. We ask you, Lord, to move mountains. Everybody got a situation going on in their life out here on this ground. This is holy ground. And Father God, we ask you to come forth in the midst. You said in your word, wherever two or three at, you're in the midst. So Father God, we thank you for being here right now. We ask you in the name of your Son, Jesus, to move mountains, move whatever obstacles that's in these people's lives. Father God, we want to be a blessing to everybody in here tonight. We ask you to bless the food that we have prepared. Let it be nourishment for our bodies. And we ask you, Lord, to move, let people get saved. Let them be able to get delivered from whatever they're going through. For Lord, it is so. You said it in your word, and you do not lie. We love you, and we honor you, and we praise your holy name. It is so. Amen.
So now we're going to get started. We're going to have an opening selection by our sister Hadassah. She wanted to assist us in praise and worship on today. Hallelujah. This is my baby.
He died on Calvary. Oh, how you gave your life for me. Bruised, scorned, cut your head with thorns. There's no love I perform for me. Nails in your hands, nails in your feet, piercing your side, could barely breathe. Could have came down, yet you remain standing in all the price you paid. I never knew what a love so true. You paid your life, and still I hurt you. For Mary cried, crucified you again. Lord, forgive me for my sins. You paid it all up on the cross. You put and died, cause I was lost. So here I am, surrendering all. Lord, hear my cries, my knees will fall. You paid it all, all. Oh, you paid all. I realize I'm no good. Ooh. And no money I can pay for exchange for the blood. Ooh, share for my sins.
Hallelujah. We have a sister coming to share a testimony. We got a sister, Sharita, coming to share a testimony. She went through the test. Now she got a testimony. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now I know y'all can do better than that. We came in this neighborhood to take back what the enemy has stolen. Y'all don't understand. My testimony is for real. I used to be right here on these streets. So God picked the right person today to tell exactly what God has done. Used to be right here selling drugs, running up and down the streets after the devil would have his way with me in my home. Come on here. Yeah. Running around looking for love in all the wrong places. But God. But God. And I came back to take back what the enemy has stolen from whatever he sends us. Amen? That's why we're here, right?
That's why we're here, right? Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise as he does what he desires to do on today. I just wanted to get that small testimony to let the enemy know that you may have some, but you just lost one, baby. You lost one. Come on here. So to God be the glory. God bless you in due season. Let's give them a hand for getting out in the highways and byways, compelling God's people to come back to him. Amen. God bless you. I love you with the love of the Lord. Amen.
We sisters and brothers in Christ, amen. We are the same family, amen. We got the same bloodline, amen. Hallelujah. So after selections, and I put an S on that to make it plural, because they know I'm greedy every time I hear them sing. They don't realize that, right? After they lift up their voices, you will hear the word from our brother pastor coming out of Fuquay from Dunamis Christian Life Center. Amen. Our brother, our pastor, Emmanuel Williams. Amen.
awesome?
Amen.
I just love him, so we're going to sing a little song because he's an awesome God.
been so good
to me.
I'm grateful,
grateful
you've been
to me.
Lord, you're a healer.
Have a
faith.
Because I have
a faith.
I'm gonna have
a
faith.
To
the this and get this going. I'll be reading from 1 Samuel chapter 19, verses 1 through 9. Is that all right? If it ain't all right, it's going to be anyhow. Amen. I ain't never scared. And Saul spake to Jonathan his son and to all his servants that they should slay David. But Jonathan, Saul's son, delighted much in David. And Jonathan told David, saying, Saul, my father seeketh to slay thee. Now therefore I pray thee, take heed to thyself in the morning, and abide in a secret place, and hide thyself. And I will go out and stand beside my father in the field where thou art. And I will commune with my father of thee. And if I see aught, I will tell thee. And Jonathan spake good of David unto Saul his father, and said unto him, let not the king sin against his servant, against David, because he have not sinned against thee. And because his works have been to thee were very good, for he put his life in his hand and smote the Philistine, and Jehovah wrought a great victory for all in Israel that saw us and didst rejoice. Wherefore then wilt thou sin against innocent blood to slay David without a cause? And Saul hearkened unto the voice of Jonathan, and Saul sware, as Jehovah liveth, he shall not be put to death. Somebody look up and say, neighbor, I ain't dying tonight.
I ain't dying tomorrow.
You will not die, but you shall live and declare the works of the Lord. You see, they had a song said it's on fire tonight, but how many know you ain't dying tonight? Oh, come on. That's all right. That's all right. Ain't none of y'all party like me. Come on, find somebody and say, you ain't dying tonight. And Jonathan called David and showed him all the things. And Jonathan brought David to Saul, and he was in his presence as before time. Our key scriptures are 8 and 9. Therefore, deal kindly with thy servant, for thou hast brought thy servant into a covenant of Jehovah. The thing jumped on me. How many know the devil can't stop God's flow?
Amen.
Let me read verses 8 and 9. And there was war again, and David went out and fought with the Philistines and slew them with a great slaughter, and they fled before him. And an evil spirit from Jehovah was upon Saul as he sat in his house with a spear in his hand.
Yes.
And David was playing with his hand. And Saul sought to smite David even to the wall with the spear. But he slipped away out of Saul's presence, and he smote the spear into the wall, and David fled and escaped that night.
Yes, sir.
Somebody say, enemy, you missed again. In Jesus' name,
you missed again.
Come on, give God praise. It can't have you. You are spoken for. In this life, there are two kind of things you can live. You can live a good life, or you can live a bad life. You can live a godly life, which is good, or you can live an evil life, which is bad. Here's the thing about good and evil. If you did not have a choice, you wouldn't have a reason to serve God. You understand? You have to have a choice of good and bad and good and evil in order to make the choice for Christ. Oh, come on. Is somebody understanding what I'm saying? How many know in this race there is no ugly? It's just good and bad. And so you got to have good and bad in order to make a choice. Now, let me share something with you really quick. The reason why bad things happen to good people is because evil knows no boundaries.
Yeah.
Evil does not know when to stop. Actually, it is evil's job to enlarge in itself and broaden itself and get you until it's consumed. Evil's job is to take part and take control until it totally consumes every part of you. There's not one person in there who can say, I've told a lie and then stop. Someone is probably wondering, why is he talking about good and bad and evil? But let me tell you something. Evil is just like a snake. It won't let up. A snake will continually pursue its prey. And evil will jump on anything that gets in the way. And so for evil that doesn't change, you need a God that changeth not. You need a God that's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. You need a God that, like when the grass withereth and the flower fadeth away, the word of the Lord shall remain forever. You see, you need a God who's the great I am. Somebody in here need a lover. Well, then you need Jesus. Somebody in here needs a comforter. Well, then you need Jesus. He said, I am. Somebody say, He is.
He is.
What you need Him to be. You need the great I am. You listen, there was a song but before I quit listening to rap music. The song said, I'll be that. How many know no matter what you need, He'll be that. If you need protection, He'll be that. If you need shelter, He'll be that. Or you need saving, He'll be. If you got destiny, we cannot have you. If you got destiny, baby, divorce cannot have you. Somebody touch somebody and say, it can't have you. You are spoken for. Come on, give God some praise. If there's a king in you, it's going to manifest itself. If there's a queen in you, she's going to manifest herself. If there is a future in you, it's going to manifest itself. You have destiny. You will not leave here before your time. It cannot have you. Promiscuity cannot have you. Addiction cannot have you. The streets cannot have you. Give God some praise. There are so many different it's. We got prideful it. We got unbelieving it. Watch this. We have ignorant it. It's not that they're dumb. They just don't know. How can these children know the love of God if you take them to soccer on Sunday? How many know tonight we gonna deal with it? Tell somebody tonight we gonna deal with it. You don't have to take this in anymore. You are spoken for. It doesn't have to have you. It won't have you. God said, I wish above all things that you would prosper. Even as your soul prosper and be in good health. Diabetes does not have to have you. High blood pressure does not have to have you. Hallelujah. 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 Would you come? It belongs to God. It is in Him that we live and move and have our being. But it does not have to have you anymore. You are God's property. Get your life back. You've got to speak good.
over yourself. God had told Hobab, he said, listen, the Lord have spoken good. We take authority in the name of Jesus. We claim victory in the name of Jesus. Now thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph. We take authority in the name of Jesus. It will no longer have him. It is no longer a part of his life. It is not in him anymore. God, we give it over to you, God. Push something out of him, God. Stir up the gift of him, God. Cause him to see what he's never saw before. Cause his eyes to see and his ears to hear. Let he that have an ear, let him hear, God. Take away the taste. Take away the desire. Take away the thirst, God. Let him never thirst or hunger anymore, God. For you are the living water. And if you drink this water, you will never thirst again. In Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Amen. And agree with you. I come from a rough place. I touch and agree with you. I know it gets rough, but sometimes it gets rough in order for it to get better. See, you've got to understand. You've got to have a bad time to know him as a good God. You need bad times to know him as a good God. Listen, Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask that you make his family, God, be a hedge all around them. Be a defense city. Be a brass and wall. Be a pillar of iron. So as the mountain camps round about Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. God, you still hear the prayer of a sinner, or it would not be called the sinner's prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. This is for everybody. Somebody shout, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Hi, I'm Yvette Michelle. How are you tonight, sir?
I'm doing fine, and yourself?
What is your name?
I'm Kenneth Evans. We're in due season.
Yes, sir. And what is the purpose of this every year?
Our purpose every year is to show the love of Jesus and to help someone else. We want to bless the community, and we want to get people out here to be able to know the love of Christ and what Christ is doing. And we out here to serve food and have some fun and fellowship and be able to bless somebody and change somebody's life. We want somebody to do better tomorrow than they did today. So that's our main goal out here, to help somebody and give them some clothes and give them some food and let them know that Jesus loves them and we love them as well. So that's our main purpose and our main cause.
Well, I really had a good time tonight, and this was a great program because God was in the midst.
Yes, well, I'm grateful that he come. You know, he said, wherever two or three at, he's in the midst. And I'm grateful that he came and showed up and showed out. And did you shop tonight? Did you get you some clothes and find you something? We had plenty of free clothes out here and pretty many shoes and a little bit of everything. So I hope you was able to shop as well.
Well, you know what I did, sir? I let someone else have this in need.
Okay.
But
well,
so I want you to tell me about what happens after the program.
Well, after the program, what we do next, we're going to have some good old country food. We're going to have some hot dogs and some hamburgers.
Okay.
We're going to have some beans and potato chips, soda, bottled water. And we just want to first give you some spiritual food. Then we're going to feed you some physical food.
Well, we're going to bless the name of Jesus because God is so good.
Yes,
and all
is.
Of this is because of Jesus. And we thank you so much. Stay tuned and enjoy the show. Hello, sir. How are you?
All right.
Can you give me your name and tell me the reason why you're here?
My name is Tony Jones. I'm here to get blessed by the Lord.
Yes, sir. So tell me about the program. Did you enjoy the show?
Yes, ma'am. Sure did. It was nice.
What did you receive tonight from the program?
I got a blessing.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate you. Hello, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Tell me your reason for coming here.
I'm just here to get some word and just, you know, meet different people and praise God.
So what did you get out of the program tonight?
I got so much out of it. I got deliverance, healing, and I just got good food. And the good food of the word.
Well, thanks for coming. Your name, please?
My name is Judy.
And Miss Judy, what did you do here tonight?
Actually, I was doing health and fitness, and we was doing people blood pressures, taking the blood pressures, and teaching them about proper food to eat as far as health care, and we was also speaking to them about their high blood pressure and staying in touch and keeping up with your blood pressure because it's very important.
Well, can I get my blood pressure checked?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Actually, I'm about to take your blood pressure.
Okay.
And I'm gonna ask you some questions. And that's to find out do you have a primary doctor?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And if you have a primary doctor, how often do you go and get your blood pressure checked? 10/82.
That's awesome.
That's awesome. That's a blessing.
It is.
It is.
Thank you so much. Yes.
And now we ask that you bless this physical food in the name of Jesus to nourish our bodies. Let no hurt, harm, or danger come nigh our dwelling. Remove all impurities from it, God. We thank you, God. We ask that you multiply it so everybody can eat and eat again. In Jesus' name we bless you. Amen. Amen.
I'm here live tonight with Antoinette Evans of In Due Season Outreach Ministries. Antoinette, tell us what happened on tonight. What's going on tonight?
Oh my goodness, we've had a wonderful night.
Yes.
From the time the music have gone on, before the preached word, someone gave their life to Christ.
Oh.
We just had a blessed altar call, and several people have given their lives to Christ, and we've had a powerful testimony, and then we just was blessed with song. I'm here to tell you, we just giving away countless amount of clothes, and now we're giving away food. God is so good. I know I can just go on and on, but I'm just so excited right now. Oh God, I'm just blessed. I'm just so grateful that he's included me in his plan to be a part of serving his people.
That's awesome.
I am just beside myself, sister.
That's so awesome. Again, we are here tonight with the wonderful anointed Antoinette Evans of In Due Season Outreach Ministries, reaching out into the highways and byways for God's people and for God's glory. Good night.
Jesus, he never fails. Heaven and earth will all pass away, but Jesus, He never fails. I tried him, he never fails. I tried him, and he never fails. Heaven and earth will all pass away, but Jesus, he'll never fail. You know why I don't need y'all to participate? Because last year around this time, I had crashed my car into a wall, a bridge. Didn't want to live. I didn't have any more options. Now we're here today because we want to win souls for Christ. Amen. And if you know that Christ may not be in your life, this is the time for you to allow him in. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
My testimony tonight is for somebody. Because the Spirit came to me and told me it was testimony. When I was a young man,
I wanted everything my way. I had no time for nobody else. It had to be my way. I demanded respect. I fought. I sold drugs. I hung out in the streets. I didn't want to go home. I didn't want to go to school. I never graduated high school. I ain't had time to read a book. I had to be the man in the streets. It was all about me. But you know, one day on the 4th of July, my life was gone because I wanted to get drunk and go out and go swimming with all the girls. I got out in the middle of the lake and I caught cramps. And nobody was around, nobody to save. And I thank God to this day. The last thing I remember seeing as I was going down in that water was a hand reaching down to grab me. When I woke up, in a hospital. That let me know that the Lord had his hands on me. There's a reason for me being here. There's a purpose. My life was predestined. And when God has something for you, God is a God of order and completion. He's not going to start something he ain't going to finish. That's not God. God does things when he blesses you, it's forever. And I'm a blessing. When he said, do not touch his anointed and do his prophet no harm. I ran the streets of New York. I ran the streets of New Jersey. I've been around people who got killed. Most of my friends I grew up with is either dead or in prison. But glory be to God, I'm standing here giving a testimony. The people I grew up with, they never thought that me would go to church, me put on a suit, me praise the Lord. That wasn't me. I was the total opposite. But see, God could come down and he will make the best out of worst situations. And I was that worst situation. But right now, I thank God for me being here. Many will come, but few are chosen. After all I've done, he sees some good in me. I'm a chosen one, so I got to give him glory. I have to give him praise. I have to magnify his name. If you give a testimony you don't realize, that's giving God praise. That's telling about the goodness of the Lord, what he's done for you. That's giving somebody else words of encouragement so they can go, they can get through what you're going through.
That's right. Amen.
That's how good God is. That's a God that I serve and that you serve also, but you just don't know it yet. You just don't know it yet because the Bible says every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. And that's just what's going to happen. That's my testimony. I thank God. Everybody, I ask y'all keep me in God's prayers.
Your presence amazes me. Your glory surrounds me. When I walked in this room, I felt your hands upon me. To think how great you are. Amen.
enemy, you know the things that's going on these streets, God, from Boyer to Tarver to Maple to Cabo to Pender to Waldrop, God. Father God, have your way in this neighborhood. Every house, God, either the most shot, that every church, God, everything that's hovered in the house, God, pull them out, God. Bring them to let them repent, God, to know, God, that who you are. Father God, we ask you right now, God, this is another year, God, that in due season been out here, God, ministering to your people, God. We ask you to bless them, God. Bless them on every hand, God. Bless them where they need be blessed at, where they think they don't need to be blessed at, God. Pour down on them, God. Give back to them everything that they poured out this year, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Every prayer, everything that they sweated over, God, you give it back to them, God. 104th, God. Then, Father, we ask you right now, you know the turn and the turmoil of what's going on in this neighborhood. You know the ones that walk the streets at night, God. You know the drug dealer, God. You know the prostitutes. You know everything about these streets, God, because you created this neighborhood, God. So we ask you, God, that you take a hover over this atmosphere right now, God. Father God, we thank you. We praise you, God, for this atmosphere being shifted, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, God. Have your way in College Park, God. Have your way with the ones, God, that don't belong over here, but come over here, God. Have your way, God, with everything in this place, God, in this region. God, we glorify you. We magnify your holy name, God. And for the ones who got saved, God, we shout hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Because we know the angels have already rejoiced. So let us rejoice. Hallelujah, God. In the name of Jesus, we glorify you, we honor you, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, and let everybody clap their hands for Jesus.
There's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child that will give him their all, give it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate and longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And he says, love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today. Serve me with your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down, let go of your idols. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth. He's searching for a heart that is desperate, longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And he says, love me with your own. Give him their own, give it all. He